our Olympians back in the country, many of them medal winners.
Yes, so we have to learn from this and continue. We are in a good way. Boxing is very strong. We have shown in numerous competitions that we have the potential to be among the best countries in the world, and this is only growing. In 2024, we definitely will be back stronger.
All right, these images that you see of several of the stars on their way back to the country at the stage. This is Neeraj Chopra, who returned to India a little while back. An absolutely remarkable performance of Neeraj Chopra, the first Indian to win a gold medal in an individual gold medal in athletics for India in decades. So this is a remarkable performance by the young man. He is a subedar in the army. The expectation is that he'll get some sort of a promotion. Of course, he's been he was picked up, not trained per se as a soldier. He was picked for his prowess as a sportsman, and he trained extensively and has done the country so proud by winning gold in the Tokyo Olympics. So lots of BSF personnel and others that you see on your screen over there. He of course is with or affiliated to the Rajputana Rifles. So let's see what happens. Is there going to be some cheer for him from the armed forces? The men over there, I don't think they are from the Rajputana Rifles. I think they are from another force. Be that as it may, it is a proud moment for our armed forces. Neeraj Chopra coming back to India as a gold medalist. And what a story he's had. Somebody who, like so many other medal winners for India, have overcome relative poverty, have succeeded on the basis of struggles made by their parents, and have gone on to bring glory to the country. As for India as a nation, what we've come back with is huge. By international standards, just a handful of medals may not account for much, and people would suggest that given our population, India needs to win a lot more. But given the fact that typically sports has been very poorly managed in our country at so many levels, to see as many medals this time around as we are seeing is very, very welcome news indeed. And these are our heroes. These are our men and women who've done our country proud at the very highest level. And perhaps they have done most of all by what they've done, which is welcome most of all, is by giving an impetus to Indian sports in the Olympics. And therefore, one would hope that the future looks bright for Indian athletics and Indian sport in the Olympics going forward. The next games are in Paris, and all of them are young stars. They are very much an inspiration for a young generation of Indians, and I think what really defined the spirit of the young squad was their goal at all levels. And this was stated over and over again: we aren't satisfied with the bronze, we are going for gold. And while that may not have ultimately resulted in some cases in a gold, the fact of the matter is that they were aiming for the best all along. And a spirit of courage, of not willing to come second, of being mentally strong, which has been a concern in the past for Indian sport across all fields, being able to actually overcome that, being able to prepare and be physically dominant at the very highest levels, to train under difficult conditions, and now fortunately to train with coaches who are among the best in the world, if not the best in the world, has had a profound impact on Indian sport. These images from Indira Gandhi International Airport in Delhi, these have been coming in over a period of time now as all of these medalists start coming in, and then they will be moving to the Ashoka Hotel in the heart of New Delhi, where they will be officially felicitated by the government of India. So this is, it seems like a marriage party, doesn't it? But these are incredible celebrations, as you can see on your screen. We've seen many of these sportsmen and sportswomen come out.